Hello, yes, standing up for the forgotten and beleaguered white working class. That's right, the working man and woman have been abandoned and forgotten by the so-called champions of the working class, the left, the socialists, the Marxists. They've abandoned the white working class. In fact, the working man and woman have been sacrificed on the altar of multiculturalism and political correctness. The left do not care about you no more. They will not be coming to rescue you and take you out of the plight you find yourselves in, lying on hospital floors, dying on hospital floors, and many, many other tragedies now being inflicted upon our people. And this has to stop, right? This has to stop now. This is a plea to those decent British nationalists that are left. Not the pantomime and circus, not the sideshow, not the Tommy Robinson show, or the National Action, or the once mighty National Front, or successful British National Party that are now in the hands of our enemies, hope not hate. Nick Lowell's Jerry Gable's Satellite Magazine, and probably the big boys, MI5, overseeing everything. I mean, genuine, real British nationalists out there. We've got to pick up the flag and start again. Kensington, here in Liverpool, commonly known as Kenya, was in the Liverpool Echo the other night. I'll leave the link below. It's at a point of total decline and probably collapse. Something similar to Detroit in America. Christ, can you believe this is now happening in towns and cities and our once Great Britain? It's hard to fathom, it's hard to contemplate what these swines have done to our country. And it's about time that we take it no more and stand up for our people, the forgotten and beleaguered white working class. We've got to do it. We've got to pick the flag up. British nationalism now is in the hands of the enemy. The left, the socialists, the Marxists, they're not coming to the aid of the forgotten, beleaguered white working class. In fact, the complete opposite. They will bury you in a tide of multiculturalism. They don't care about you, right? They don't care. Well, some of us do, and I'm one of them. And I'm going to produce the best election address you've ever seen in the history of British nationalism. Trust me, I will. Right? Vote for a man who can bite as well as bark will be my battle cry. And I'm going to do well. Trust me. Right? Trust me. Okay, thank you.